This conference will now be recorded.
All right, guys, as always, everything that we're going to be talking about today is for educational purposes only, and nothing is intended as any type of investment advice. So SDC finally made its move. And of course, it was pretty much right after I had to leave. But let's talk about it for a second. So very interesting coming up to this 10 level. Doug had put it out there. We had over 100,000 shares that was sitting at 10, and we literally just went over this in our last Traders Exchange, what a market maker trap is. So what was happening is it wasn't a bad sign that it didn't hit that 10 level. Basically, what it was telling us is that they were building up their shares. But as we know, when we see somebody come in that hard at that 10 and with that big of an order at that 10, what retail's going to do is they're going to end up selling, which is a perfect case scenario for somebody that's trying to build a position to then break it over the 10. So obviously, we know we had just an absolutely huge amount of aspirants that came in at that 10 level. Then on its way up from that on its way up, that 1050 had what, give or take, maybe about 10 prints somewhere in that area. So we have beautiful buying at 10. We have beautiful buying at 1050. Now, we know that we got a huge amount of selling that came into 1075. When I say huge amount of selling, it wasn't really that crazy in comparison to how long that they were building up to break over that 10 and then how much buying we actually had at 10 and then 1050. And you can see a few more aspirants are actually coming in at 1050 now. So overall, going to be expecting the pullback. I'm not expecting a huge, you know, well, I mean, based off its personality, it has shown that it, you know, based off its pullbacks, we're looking at about 50 cents, give or take, in that area. But you could see the first one that came in right here, once we had aspirants at 950, we ended up pushing down to 9. Then the second one that we came in, we ended up pushing down to about 950 based off of the buying that we had underneath 10. So it was another one about 50 cents. So overall, based off of those aspirants, I would not be shocked to see this come back down to 10 before being able to push back up. But overall, I'm not expecting a huge amount just because its personality has not shown that. So we know based off 10 and 1050 that this thing definitely somebody needs to make more money than the highs that we can see at that 1085. There's no question behind that. It's really just going to be about that pullback and then obviously getting a real trigger that comes in to show us that the stock is going to be able to continue itself. Now, also keep in mind, remember how long the consolidation sitting here was. And I kind of explained it, right, of course, right before I left and it actually made its move. But I explained how the fact that's a different stock. Never mind. We'll get to that one. But overall, like I said, okay, I'm going to be expecting, you know, we're already coming down towards that. We're starting to see more buying coming in, but just off those aspirants at 1050 from the first time up, I really would like to see a little bit more. But like I said, overall has the buying to break 11 without a shout of a doubt. Shadow of a doubt. Next thing looking at is LK. This thing has just been so nice to us. I mean, it's really has not been a hard trade whatsoever. So right now we know that there's been selling in it all day. Really what I want to pull up, and it's not going to let me come in. So we did get some aspirants that just came that second time, but look at the selling that we got at 33.50 right here. That was on its way down right here. If we pull it up, just so you can see what the time frame was 118. So basically, it was on its way down. So we're pulling up from that. We have some ask riders that are showing us that we should definitely get up to at least that 34 from there. But then we're going to be looking for it to come back down. There's more new selling coming into this thing every single time we've been watching it. So it gets its pullbacks, okay? But then it's been acting fairly quickly with its huge prints that we're seeing. And once again, the personality of this thing, it's had no problem printing a huge amount. So got to keep that in mind when we're looking at long-term versus short-term, but either way, we're going to be looking at least up to that 34 before we'd be looking for a trigger back down to then now satisfy the selling prints that we have at the 33.50. But once again, riders coming in 33.50, you can see right here, and then 33.60, a little bit. Overall, still getting that selling though. So overall down, but we're going to be looking for that pull up first. Okay, then I have two sideless stocks that we're going to be looking at. Now, the first one was ZN. And now ZN, this is like on the bottom of your side list. If you trade a lot of shares of cheap stocks like this, this is, not a bad thing to look at. And the reason I'm saying this is because it's just so cheap, but it's actually sitting in a perfect pattern for what we look for in these cheaper stocks. And when I was actually scanning, it was right about, 10 before, and you can see it started to make a pretty decent move. Now the volume didn't really get there, so that's why we didn't really see much. But if we let me come back down, you can see right here. So 36, 37. We definitely did get some nice buying coming in there. So this is, like I said, on the bottom of my sign list, but I'm going to be keeping an eye on it to see if we can get some type, you know, you never know, especially for something that's 35 cents. Now, next thing is CDE. CDE I'm going to be looking at because it's just such a smooth trading stock. It moved a dollar today and volume's absolutely phenomenal in comparison to what we usually have. We're over double sitting there. Now, coming down over to that 7 on its way back up, you can see 698. We had some decent prints and then 7 a little bit. So there's not anything that's too special. And this volume right here for a $7 stock needs to pick up big time. 14,000 shares a minute is not going to be it whatsoever. That's why both these stocks are on our side list. But once again, it's a slow mover. It's definitely a lower level trading type stock. So definitely worth looking at. It's just we're going to need to see the volume pick up for us to even think about looking for a trade within it. And then other than that, guys, there's not really much else out there that that I'm paying too much attention to besides the CRWD. So CRWD called out this morning by Keith has just been kind of on a tear. 514. This is what I was talking about before when we were talking about our range. We got some ask prints that came in at that 54, but the range was underneath $3. And based off of the puzzle that we had here, we needed to go up higher. And one thing that we know is that when a stock's sitting in a consolidation like this, okay, after it gets its pop up, most people are going to be long from that consolidation. So when we were coming up to that 53, then we pulled back to 52 and saw that selling. This is very likely a spot where our computer was just set up to, if it breaks 52 or hits 52, that it's going to sell off part of its position. So I couldn't take that as shorting and not being able to hit its range first. Remember that path of least resistance. And as we can see, it in no way whatsoever disappointed us. $5.14. We're coming up to that 56 where we got some more nice aspirins that came into this thing that we're starting to pull back from. 55 is a pretty hard level to hold. Remember, big psychological level, but overall does have that buying up top. So if we hold, we get a trigger back up, 56 the level. And once again, it's just it's got a ton of buying coming into it today. So keep in mind when you're looking at these sell prints that come in, what do the sell prints mean? Can you find them definitively or are they kind of up in the air? Remember, someone that's selling a position that's long doesn't need to make money. Somebody that's shorting a position does need to make money. And there's a big difference between that. And when you have a stock that was sitting in consolidation that long and then kind of breaking out upwards from it, we can assume what we know the people during that consolidation were doing, which in this case would be buying. So selling, we know is going to happen. Always going to be really interested in making sure that we get that new buy. All right, guys, anything else out there that I missed? Anything else going on out there that I missed? I think that is about it. All right, beautiful. So let's get ready for our afternoon time. We definitely got some stuff to look at, you know, for some extended moves. So, you know, it's not looking like too bad of an afternoon whatsoever. So I will talk to everyone in the chat room and happy trading.